All right, welcome everyone to a new tutorial on plate solving in EKOS. In specific, I'm going to show you how to use the EKOS Polar Align Assistant. In the previous video, I have demonstrated how to prepare for plate solving by downloading the proper index files and double-checking some of the settings within EKOS. If you have these set up, you are good to go. If you're not sure, you can check the video linked in the description to ensure that you have set up everything correctly. Now, since I've uploaded the previous video, something exciting has happened. KSTARS 3.5.2 got released. And in 3.5.2, there's actually a whole redesigned version of the Polar Align Assistant. Now, I will not be showing you the new version of the Polar Align Assistant in this video. Simply because most of you will not be upgrading immediately, or at least I wouldn't recommend it without testing. So you will probably still be working on a slightly older version of KSTARS, and I want this video to be relevant to you too. Also, I want to have a little bit more time to test the new Polar Align Assistant myself. I've played around with it for a bit and it didn't always behave exactly the way I expected, so I definitely need to do some more testing. That's why in this video I'll show you the Polar Align Assistant of KSTARS 3.5.1. So let's dive in. First, we'll navigate back to the alignment module. Usually, after I set up my telescope, I'll double check my polar alignment before I do anything else. What I can do is I will go to this lower middle panel. Currently, it is set to the tab that shows me the solution results. And right next to it, you have a tab that's reserved for polar alignment. So when I press the Polar Alignment tab, you can see that I'm now presented with the Polar Align Assistant. It is basically a wizard where I can move through the steps of polar aligning. There's a couple of things I want to point out to you. First, you must make sure that your capture settings are correct. So I've selected the right camera and a good exposure. This doesn't have to be a very long exposure, usually 1 second is enough. You just need to see some stars that can be solved by EKOS. I'll choose 2 seconds since I want the stars to be visible on the screen recording. If you are using a filter wheel, make sure it is set up correctly. I'm not using a filter wheel right now, so I have to turn it off. And one more thing, I want to show you that it's okay to have your mount parked for polar alignment. You need to unpark your mount for all the other operations, but for simply calculating your polar misalignment, you can leave the mount parked, that's no problem. And I'm back in the Polar Alignment Wizard. What's going to happen is that EKOS will take 3 images when I press start, and it will rotate my mount in between those images. That way, EKOS can calculate my polar misalignment and tell me what I need to do to fix it. On the first screen, it presents me with a couple of options. First of all, what will be the interval between those 3 images. And currently, and by default, it's set to 30 degrees interval. Which is great. I've never needed to change that. And EKOS will rotate my mount westward, which in my case is fine, but perhaps you have some obstructions or whatever. And here you can change it to go eastward as well. Another option you have here is to change your mount speed during the polar alignment process. Now the telescope simulator only has 4 rates: guide, centering, find, and max. But your own telescope driver might have many more. For instance, the EQ mod driver, which I usually use, has a whole list of different speeds that I can choose from. And if you set it too slow, the polar alignment process might take a while. I've now set it to find, and what I'll do now is I'll press start, and EKOS will take the first image. So, EKOS is now capturing the first image. And it's solving the image, and it has already found a result. And now it's rotating the mount. You can see that over here. And it's already taking the second image. It's capturing it. Then it will solve the image, then come back with the result. And now it's rotating the mount again for a second time. And it's already taking a third image. calculating it. And it came up with my polar misalignment. As you can see right now, I have 35 minutes and 32 seconds of polar error. And I can also see that plotted graphically in the image above. If we look a little bit closer, what you can see is, you can see this purple line. So this purple or magenta line displays my polar error. On one side, you have this red crosshair. And what you can do with it is you can select one of the stars. My advice would be to select a star that has very few other stars, in this case, left to it. So if I, for instance, select this star over here, I can zoom in a little bit, make sure that it's really click, that I really click this star. You now see that this magenta line has become the path that this star needs to travel to end up in this target. Now I can press the next button and I can choose a refresh rate. I'll just refresh it every, let's say, 2 seconds, because then the stars will be bright enough to show on the screen recording. Usually I would select 1 second. And you can press refresh. Don't accidentally press the done button, because then it will reset your mount without doing any of the polar alignment you wanted. Press the refresh on the left side. So EKOS now refreshes this image over here every 2 seconds. What I do now is I would go to my mount and adjust the altitude and azimuth screws until the star ends up in the red target. And we're back. I've adjusted the knobs on my mount and I came up with a place that I think is pretty much as good as it's going to get. Now that that's done, I can press the done button. And what it will do now is it will reset my mount back to its park position. Now, if I want to know how much better my current polar alignment is compared to what I had earlier, I will need to do a completely new polar alignment. I'm back at the beginning of the wizard. My mount is in its park position and now I can press start again. The Polar Align Assistant will again take 3 images. It will solve them and it will tell me the results. And as you can see, my current polar error is only 36 arc seconds, which is a lot better than the 35 minutes and 32 seconds that I had a couple of minutes ago. I'm not going to change it. This is good enough for me. So I can just press stop and it asks me whether I'm sure that I want to stop. Then I say yes. And now it will set my mount back to its original position. And I can start my imaging session. And with that, we've come to the end of this video. In the next video, we'll continue to explore the alignment module. I'll show you the go-to operations that use blade solving. If you are interested in that, keep an eye on the channel. If you found this video useful, please consider giving it a like. As always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to post them below. And for now, take care and I'll see you later.